Hi guys, welcome back to this second part of the tutorial about RekordBox 7. Today I'm going to show you a bit deeper stuff. I'm not gonna do like the expert RekordBox. This is the second part of the tutorial, so by the end of this video, if you understand fully what I'm gonna show you, you're already ready. You're gonna be fully ready with USB drive for your first gigs. You don't need actually more than this. I never, almost never use more than this. But if you're a laptop DJ, you have much more functionalities that you can use afterwards. But as a USB drive DJ, this is fully what you need. First, we're gonna create folders, create playlists and sort them in these folders by music genres, by key, by BPM, or even by energy. Put from 1 to 5 stars energy, depends on what you like. So you know which track you play when you want to drop a little bit energy in your gig, and those tracks that you're gonna find out when you need a little bit to kick off with some bangers in the mix. Let's check this out. And under the folder, we have different playlists, depends of different genres. So how to create this? This was made for the school. So now let's start with something completely new and fresh. I want to show you first, I have this compilation that I bought from Beatport. As you can see, I have different compilations that I buy here for the school. So this is from Tool Room. And if I click, I have like over 60 tracks. First, I get a lot of this question, why you buy music? I will show you the main digital stores that we have right now for DJs. I mean, this is what all DJs, they do their shoppings. First, we have tracksource.com. It has different music genre, as you can see here, depends what you want to go for. Just select the one and you can follow up by DJ charts. You can have different artists putting their tracks. They select the best tracks of the week, of the month, and here, you know, what shots. Also, the best-selling track, single, and albums. So here you can see you have different music genres. So you can really spend hours and hours to find new music. Second, we have a beatport.com. This one is more familiar to most people. You also have more genres here. You can really find a lot of different type of music as well. And you can see also you have top selling tracks, and you can have also the hype tracks, top 10, and you can click here and go for top 100. You have different artists also putting their future charts every week or every month. And you have the high picks from the Beatport. So this is basically, you can spend hours to find tracks based on label, artists, and you know, just need to search and dig. You need to love what you're doing if you want to spend hours here. If not, you're gonna say, oh shit, I have to find new music again, I have to spend hours. If you ask that question to yourself, it means something is not set in the program. Anyway, so when I get this compilation, it's ready here to go. So I go back to my RekordBox and I can create first a folder. So I click right on the playlist and I say create new folder. Okay. Now I have the folder entitled folder here. Just double click on it to change the name. Since my compilation is called Tool Room, I'll just call it Tool Room. That's my main folder. And then now let's start with a main compilation. Say like this, I'll just say compilation, and I will drag and drop all the tracks that I have from here from my folder. I will select the first. These are mixes, so I don't need them. And I go to the last one, I click shift to my keyboard, and then I will select the last track. And you can see here, I can drag. Oh, sorry. I will do it again. It happened. So select the first one, and then I click shift on my keyboard, select the last one. Now I can have them all. So drag and drop the tracks. And you see, All of them are here, and I have over 50 tracks for like $12. So it's really interesting. Now that I have my compilation here, you can see in the genre I have different genres. So if I sort by genre, you can really see tech house, I have house, minimal, you know, different. I don't have much afro or deep house. So let's focus on three music genres: house, minimal, and tech house. So first I'll create my playlist called Tech House. Maybe I will just take that space between, okay. And then I come back to my compilation. When I sort by genre, I select the first track of Tech House, shift on my keyboard, and then the last one, drag and drop them into my playlist Tech House. Click on Tech House, I only have Tech House tracks here. You see, it's better to play tracks based on genre. Don't keep things messy in one folder or in one playlist, because it's gonna take you more time to find the right track to play while you're having a gig than playing itself. Come back to my compilation. Let's say the other genre was minimal tech. So I come here again, click plus, create a new minimal or deep tech, let's call it deep tech. This is a new playlist, empty. Come to my compilation. I select this minimal stuff here. Don't have that many, but it's okay to create an example. Click on my deep tech and I have all of my tracks here. Last but not least, let's call the last one called house. Okay, because I saw many house tracks in that compilation. Sort by genre again, select the first one, shift and the last one, then drag and drop into my playlist. See here, I have three different playlists with three different music genre. Good. So basically, I don't need this one anymore, except if I want to use the rest of the tracks. But let's say for this example, I just take it out. Delete playlist. It doesn't delete the tracks that was in place. It's only deleted the playlist. The tracks that I've been dragging and dropping into my playlist, if I want to delete them, I need to come into the main collection here, you know, display collection. I say all, and then I search for the track here, and then I take it out. Now let's go back to my playlist. Now when I'm finished, before that I export into my USB drive, let's work out the keys. Let's sort some tracks based or in key. If I come here in my playlist, this is the second part here, and I go under my folder, let's say I wanna take the Tech House compilation. You can see here all the Tech House tracks, but now what I can do, this player A, you see this? When it's enabled, tracks in the browser area that match the key of the loaded track are highlighted in green, which means that if I take any of these tracks from this playlist and I drag it and I drop it into this player, all the tracks that are in key are going to be a green. You see? It's beautiful. If I take another one, it will change the tracks in green. That depends. It doesn't mean that they have to be all GM and CM. You know, music key go from A to F. So some of them, they fit in the same harmony. So CM, for example, goes well with GM because they are in harmony. You don't need to go to details now, but you just listen to the record box. It tells you that these tracks are matching in key. You can trust it. Now, don't forget, this is very important. You don't sort your playlist by key if it's not in the same music genre, because you don't want to play one track after the other one, like hip hop after techno track, because they have the same key. No, first it needs to be in the same music genre, and then I sort them by key, because if I can hear these two tracks, this one. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Hey girl.
And if I take this one, let's see if they fit together. To me, they sound in the same genre, they sound very perfect together. This is how you do it. So now let's say I want to play this track first, and then this one, I can just drag it and drop it after the track, and I can keep doing the same thing. You see these tracks, they all fit together, same music genre. I listen to them, I like them. This is important what I'm saying. You need to like the tracks, not because they have the same key that you need to play them. First, you need to like the tracks, they need to be in the same genre, and then the same key. And when they are in the same genre, the BPM is not far away from each other. Keep that in mind. Now what I have done this, let's move to the last part, which is the rating. And you can see here these stars, it makes the tracks, like when you see this track has 5 stars, it means from to me, it's a banger, it's something high energy. If I put 2 stars, it says like, okay, this is a low energy track. I can start with it, or I can drop the energy for the crowd when it needed. And when I have mid energy, I just click 3 stars. This is my language. I understand my own. You can have your own. Whatever stars you put, you can just have your language and you understand. But keep in mind that this functionality is only working with RekordBox if you play with laptop. You don't have access to this rating, in my knowledge. Maybe I'm missing this, but I don't know. I don't think that you can have a view of the rating on the screen of your ex-DJ Pioneer DJ controller. Why we put in these stars? Because you cannot plan your mix the whole night one after the other. This is probably if you want to record a mix or something, or if you want to do like an opening very early, that's okay. But if you play in during the really busy time, you need to have more understanding of your playlist and make sure that you play in the tracks that they fit into the gig on that time, on that moment for that crowd. There is no planning like one from track 1 to track 20. Everybody has a plan until they get a punch on the face. Now that you're ready, I can export the whole folder into my USB drive by just clicking right on my mouse and I say export to my USB key. It says that, oh, the folder already exists. Then you say okay. Say okay. It will just replace all the changes that you have made. If you put tracks up and down, if you deleted tracks, if you add the tracks, the algorithm will look for what you have made as a change and it will update it. Now, if you don't have the mouse right, you can just also click on the playlist first. And then go to the menu here and say export playlist, and you select again the same thing, say okay. When everything is ready, it goes very fast, and here we go, your USB drive is up to date. That's it, folks. I think this was quite simple. I hope you enjoyed the video, but keep in mind, guys, music is first. It's all about music. DJing to me is 80% about music. So take really your time to search, looking for tracks, and the tracks that are not working well in your playlist, take them out. Don't keep them. Keep only quality. That has been said. I'll see you guys in the next video. Cheers.